Everyone, I am Dinesh. Welcome you all to the online lecture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about one more important concepts of the chapter matrix and determinant. Here, we are going to discuss about the Cayley-Hamilton theorem. This is very important in examination point of view as well as the understanding point of view. Okay. So, in this theorem, we are going to describe about what's the theorem and its proof, along with its application. So let's start without wasting time. Okay, so what the statement of Cayley-Hamiltonian theorem? The Cayley-Hamiltonian theorem in linear algebra basically states that every square matrix satisfies its own characteristics equation. So how to find its characteristics equations? There is in second point, you can find let A be a n cross n matrix and IN is the n cross n identity matrix, obviously. Then the characteristics polynomial of A defined as P lambda, that's equals to determinant of A minus lambda IN. Obviously, as you find the IN value of a matrix using the characteristics polynomial, with the same way you just find the characteristics polynomial of a matrix, then obviously this P lambda is a nth degree polynomial of the scalar lambda. So the Cayley-Hamiltonian theorem states here, defines that if we define an analogous matrix, if you define an analogous matrix equation P of A, here you get P of lambda as a nth degree polynomial of lambda, but if you define an analogous matrix P of A just by replacing lambda by the matrix A, you have to replace lambda, the scalar quantity, the scalar number, by the matrix A, then you will obviously get a characteristic equation of A which is equals to a zero matrix. That's according to Cayley-Hamilton theorem. So you can verify this Cayley-Hamilton theorem using a very good example of order 2 cross 2. So let's see and verify Cayley-Hamilton theorem first, then we will see its application in matrix algebra. Okay, so let's assume an arbitrary matrix of order 2 cross 2 as 1 2 3 4. This is very simple to assume a 2 cross 2 matrix. So let's find its characteristics polynomial first, just by taking phi lambda is your characteristic polynomial equals to simply the determinant of A minus lambda I. Obviously here lambda I2, because this is a 2 cross 2 matrix, so we require a 2 cross 2 identity matrix. Okay, so if you take the determinant of A minus lambda I, this will be of the form 1 minus lambda 2 3 4 minus lambda, determinant which is equals to 1 minus lambda into 4 minus lambda minus 6, that's equals to 4 minus lambda minus 4 lambda plus lambda square minus 6, which equals to lambda square minus 5 lambda minus 2. Obviously, you get your phi lambda, the characteristics polynomial of the form lambda is lambda square minus 5 lambda minus 2. So for from Cayley-Hamiltonian theorem, we can define a matrix P of A, a matrix P of A, by replacing lambda as the matrix A, which will be equals to 0. So from Cayley-Hamiltonian theorem, you can write from Cayley-Hamilton theorem, just P of A equals to 0. So how can you find P of A? Just by replacing lambda by the matrix A. So P of A is your implies, you can write A square minus 5A minus 2 equals to 0. So for this matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, you get its characteristics equation A square minus 5A minus 2 equals to 0. So let's verify this term to get a 0 matrix. This 0 is nothing but a 0 matrix of order 2 cross 2, that is 0, 0, 0, 0. So how to verify? You just find A square. If you will find A square, you will get, if you find A square for this matrix, you obviously get 1, 2, 3, 4 into 1, 2, 3, 4. I have already done lecture on finding the square of a matrix or matrix multiplication. Simply, you will get as 7, 10, 15 and 22. For this matrix, A square is 7, 10, 15 and 22. Okay. So if you get 5a, you will just multiply 5, which is a number, into all the elements of a matrix. You will get 5, 10, here 15, here 20, okay? And simply 2, here 2 means 2i, 2. Obviously, it's a number, so you can define the number in a form of matrix just by multiplying it with a identity matrix of that order. Okay, so here 2i2, we can just write 2002. Okay, so if you substitute all the value a square minus 5a minus 2i2, you will get here, if you substitute a square minus 5a minus 2i2, you will obviously get 7, 10, 15, 22 minus 5, 10, 15, 20 and minus 2, 0, 0, 2. This will result as 0, 0, 0, 0 matrix. Okay. In this, we can verify the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, and every matrix satisfies its characteristic equation. So for this matrix, the characteristics equation you get P of A equals to 0, that is A square minus 5A minus 2i2 equals to 0. So let's see what's its application. So why we read this actually? Because it helps in finding the any power of a matrix. You can find A square, A cube, A4, A to the power n with the application of Cayley-Hamilton theorem using this characteristic equation. So let's see how we can find the nth power of a matrix using the characteristic equation. We have seen the characteristic equation for this matrix is A square minus 5A. You can write it as PA equals to simply your A square minus 5A minus 2i2, which is equals to 0. So this is your characteristic equation for this matrix. So how can you utilize this characteristic equation? You can write it here implies A square is equal to simply just take 5A and 2i2. This side you will get 5A plus 2i2. So you easily find out A square by using the matrix A and using an identity matrix. If you go for A cube, you just multiply A with A square. Just here you will get 5A square plus 2A. Now replacing A square from this. This is 1, this is 2. So from this 2, you just replace the value of A square, you will get 5 into 5A plus 2i2 plus 2A, from which you will get 25A plus 10i2 plus 2A, which is equals to your 27A plus 10i2. You just get A cube, 3 times multiplication of the same matrix as a linear combination of A and i2. In this way, you can write An for this matrix, you can write An is equal to alpha A plus beta i2. Just alpha and beta are nothing but a number or scalar. Okay. So in this way, you can find the nth power of a matrix by using the characteristic equation from Cayley-Hamilton theorem. So it's very applicable. Okay. Or another application, most useful application, to find the inverse of a matrix. To find the inverse of a matrix. So from this example, using this characteristic equation, I have put a point to the inverse of a matrix. So the characteristic equation is a square minus 5a minus 2i2 equals to 0. So just multiply a inverse both sides. So we will get here a minus 5i, obviously a into a inverse equals to I, minus 2 a inverse equals to 0. So from here you will get 2 a inverse equals to a minus 5i implies a inverse equals to 1 by 2 a minus 5i. Okay, this is very simple way to calculate a inverse of a matrix. Let's verify a inverse. Okay, I have already done lecture on finding a inverse of 2 cross 2 as well as 3 cross 2, 3 cross 3 matrix in a very simple way. You can see previous lecture to get the inverse of a matrix within second. Okay, so from this Cayley-Hamiltonian theorem also you can find the a inverse in very simple way. Okay, so if you find the a inverse of this matrix, you will just have to do this operation, a minus 5i divided by 2. So a inverse is nothing but 1 by 2. If you do a minus 5i, you will get simply 1, 2, 3, 4 is your a, minus 5i is your 5, 0, 0, 5. So you will get 1 by 2, 1 minus 5, this is minus 4, 2, 3, minus 1. So this is your minus 2, 1, 3 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. So how simply you calculate the inverse of this matrix, and if you directly find the inverse of this matrix using the rule, you also verify that the inverse of a matrix is this matrix. So this is your A inverse for this matrix A. Okay, in this way you can find the application of Cayley-Hamilton theorem, and I hope you understand the way and your homework. You just verify the Cayley-Hamilton theorem for higher order matrix, higher order square matrix obviously. Okay, so for this matrix you can verify by finding the inverse of A in other method, and verify the inverse of this matrix using Cayley-Hamilton theorem. I hope this lecture will helpful for you, and please share the video with your friends, and never forget to subscribe the channel to get the uploading. Okay, I hope it will help you better. Thank you so much.